What's good, YouTube? It is time for Vlogmas number 13. So, it's gonna be a two-part Vlogmas. The first half, I'm going to talk about my five top favorite Christmas movies. And then the second half, I'm going to do a review on the Netflix movie Jingle Jangle. So, let's go ahead and get into this and cue the intro. All right, guys. So, my five top favorite Christmas movies. We're gonna do this from five back to one because I have to save some type of suspense for you guys to get to the first one. So, number five, they're all top ones, so like it just means I like one more than the other one. But for number five, I would definitely have to say Holiday Heart. Now, anybody who has seen Holiday Heart knows the amount of sadness that this movie can get. So that's pretty much why it's number five, but it's also a real life story. So like this could really happen to a family and it's legit heartbreaking. So that is why it's number five. If you have not watched Holiday Heart, I'm going to give you a little detail about the movie. It's been a while since I've seen it, but Ving Rhames, who is one of the three main characters, he plays a drag queen who basically lost his other half. So when he loses his other half, like he meets this little girl, he becomes like really attached to her and starts playing the role of like a father figure in her life. Her mother, on the other hand, gets addicted to drugs and falls in love with her dealer. So she becomes under the influence of doing like whatever he asks her, and it starts to endanger the child. So that's kind of where Ving Rhames' character steps in and tries to take over for the little girl. And it ends up adding conflict to the story because the little girl wants her mother to go down the straight and narrow path, and her mom, with her addiction, doesn't like she's under the influence, like, and she doesn't think that she's going to be able to do so because she's so messed up from all the drugs she's been taking. And she's so eager to please this drug dealer boyfriend she has. I'm not going to go into any more about this, but just know that it is a very, very touching and heartbreaking story. If you have not seen it, definitely see it, but be prepared to shed some tears because it's just that deep. And it's number five because it's so emotional. Like, I am the type of person, like, I know that life gets emotional and everything, but I don't want to be super, super sad around Christmas time. And with this movie, it was really sad around Christmas time. But it's really touching as well. Number four, another classic. I think it came out before Holiday Heart did, but you kind of have to keep this movie in the loop. Featuring my girl, Whitney Houston. It's where I learned how to blow from. You know, guys know I can blow, I can sing, okay? It's where I got my voice from. She told me everything I know.
Bruh.
Everything I know. And because I'm saying this, you guys probably know what movie I'm about to say next. The Preacher's Wife. That is a classic that has to always be in your top five. You cannot have a top five Black Christmas movie list without that one in there. It is a classic. It will ever be, forever be a good movie. And those of you who haven't seen Preacher's Wife need to go see it. And here is a little bit about that movie as well. Washington, one of the main characters in this movie, is like this emissary. So he was sent down from basically heaven to help this preacher come up with a way to, I forgot, like, what was he, I forgot. Oh my gosh, you guys, I forgot what he was sent down for, but he was basically to help the preacher. And the preacher was Whitney Houston's husband. I'm going to have to watch like all of these movies after I post this because I need a refresher. But he was to help Whitney Houston's husband, who was the preacher, and hence the preacher's wife. And in coming down, like, he becomes really attached to like their son and Whitney Houston's character. So, Denzel, knowing that he's an angel and should kind of distance himself, tries to, but like the preacher's so busy and he doesn't even realize that he's neglecting his marriage and basically pushing them together. And Whitney Houston's mother in the movie is so gung-ho about this new man that's always around helping, and she tries her best to try to get Whitney's character to basically leave her husband and even and consider this new man. But like around the end, they kind of come closer together because the Reverend comes to a revelation that what he's doing is actually neglecting his family. And he tries to put himself back on the right track. And Denzel's character kind of realizes that his job is there to bring them closer together and not separate them. So he has to have like this thought within himself, like, I need to stay on task about what I'm down here for. Because like, you have to think, like, as an angel coming from a place where you basically know only the right things to do, as it's portrayed, and you're coming to Earth where you have so many new possibilities, so many new experiences that you didn't have when you were like up there. Like, you're tempted, and it's really hard to stay on the right path. But at the end of the movie, he ends up bringing them closer together. It has a happy ending, and then he basically just walks away and goes back up. They celebrate Christmas, everything's good, and it's just a beautiful movie. A beautiful classic movie that needs to be in you guys' top five. So that's all I'm going to say about that movie. If you guys have not seen A Preacher's Wife, definitely go see it. I'm trying to think, I believe it came out in the 90s, if I'm not mistaken, the late 90s, probably 97, 98. I don't know. If anybody knows, comment down below when this movie actually came out. But that is my number four. So on to my number three. All right, guys. So number three in my pickup, my top favorite Christmas movie lineup, has to be The Perfect Holiday. If you have seen this movie, you know it is a complete love story, which I love love stories. Gabrielle Union and Morris Chestnut come together as one. So Gabrielle Union plays this single mother of three kids who they have like this hilarious Charlie Murphy character who plays this rapper who blew up and kind of neglected the kids and the family. So he's always promising the kids that he's going to come around and spend more time with them, like pick them up and just hang out with them. Like, the oldest boy is more attached to him than the other two, but the other two want to be around their dad as well. But it affects the older child the most. So like, he's really burdened by the fact that his dad's not showing them as much attention as he wants them to. And so when Morris Chestnut's character kind of comes into the movie and he sees his mom getting like really close with him, he starts to fear that like this guy is going to try to take my dad's place. I need to do something to break him up. So he comes up with all these schemes or whatever to try to keep them from like falling in love, which are failed attempts because you have Terrence Howard's character and Queen Latifah's character. So they kind of play like this good, bad angel type thing. Terrence Howard tries to go for breaking them up. And Queen Latifah's character kind of pushes them together because she wants to see it happen. And she's on the verge of fighting for good. So it kind of becomes like a bigger comedy skit with this. You also have Faison Love in there, who becomes the boyfriend of Gabrielle Union's character's best friend, which also adds some little bit more comedy in there. So overall, like through the oldest boys' failed attempts, they become closer together anyway. And Morris Chestnut character always seeing like their dad as this person to look up to. He wanted to get a record deal with him because Morris Chestnut's character was also a singer. So one day when he finally meets him, like he passes a song and they end up stealing his song and remaking it as the dad's voice with him trying to sing on it. So long story short, you guys, end of the movie, like Gabrielle Union realizes that she does indeed love this man, and they come together and they end up being one cute big happy family. The deadbeat father tries to change his ways and ends up accepting Morris Chestnut in her life. So I mean, it's just a really cute love story with a bunch of comedy. So definitely go check it out if you have not. My top three. The next one. I mean, yeah, that's all I'm gonna say about that movie, guys. You have to go watch it. I love it. I've seen it multiple times. That's why I'm like so up to knowledge on that one. Based off of the other two, because I wasn't completely there. But yeah, my top three. So, number two would have to be This Christmas. This Christmas, hands down, number two. This Christmas is just so full of love. The songs are bomb. Everything about it is just so family oriented. And I feel like I love the whole big family thing. There's tons of love in there. I especially love the part where what is her name? Regina King. Is it Regina King? I think it's Regina King. Regina King's character comes to the realization and dumps her deadbeat husband and crashes the car. I mean, like, it just has so many elements of love, pain, heartbreak, comedy, togetherness, acceptance. Like, the movie is just everything. So for those of you who've never seen This Christmas, definitely go watch it. I did post on this video that it's going to be a bunch of spoilers for these five movies if you have not seen them. So This Christmas is basically about a mom trying to get all her family back together, hoping that all her family comes back together for Christmas. Her husband is out of the picture, and she's not ready to have the family accept this new guy as being her new partner, especially her older son, who has been away from home for a while, being on some sketchy business that nobody in the family even knew about until like the middle of the movie. But he ends up coming Christmas trying to get away from some sketchy people. And this guy is played by Idris Elba, if you have not seen it. So that's kind of his character. He becomes more accepting of his mom's relationship towards the end. And then you have Lauren London's character, who is like the favorite daughter or whatever, and the youngest, who's away from college, can't really make up her mind on like what she wants to do. So she's kind of like an undecided student, but she brings her boyfriend along home for Christmas. And you know, she has like brothers just grilling them and whatever. Then you have Regina Hall's character, who's married. I think she had like two kids. It was either two or three kids with Laz Alonso's fine self. But they had two kids, but he had this assistant that he was always sneaking away with and cheating on his wife with. So like Regina Hall knew the whole time, and it caused conflicts with her between her other sister, and I cannot think of the character's name. What was her name? Hold on, guys. I'm gonna have to look it up. I'll be back. All right, guys. So her name was Sharon Leal. She played, I think she was like the middle sister, and then Regina King's character was supposed to be like the oldest sister, or maybe it's vice versa. I can't really remember. But like Sharon Leal's character was like this popular cheerleader girl in like school, and like this is where Mekhi Phifer's character come in, like, because he was like this geeky guy who had the biggest crush on her. She didn't really notice him until like she shows back up home for Christmas, and he kind of had the whole glow up going, and she's like, wow. And so they kind of become a couple or whatever during this movie, and she realizes that she's actually feeling him. And then you have Columbus Short, which is another one of the brothers. He is kind of like this army brat who went away and had like this secret relationship with a Caucasian woman, and was kind of keeping her on the down low from his family, so they didn't really know like what her importance was to the family until she finds out that she's pregnant and shows up, because the army realized that Columbus Short's character had gone AWOL. So they kind of find him after this party brawl at a club, and he's put in a jail cell to wait until the army comes. And you know, if you're familiar with how the army works, you probably know the whole process. Me, not too much. I just know what happened in the movie. But like I said, his wife comes to them and lets them know that she's pregnant, and hey, I'm your sister-in-law kind of deal. So it took a while for like Regina King's character to accept him, as well as like Sharon Leal's. Lauren London's character was like the one to like first kind of accept her and talk to her, because she realized how upset she was and alone, and they kind of just take care of her until Columbus Short shows back up at the end to be a part of the life and for Christmas. So yeah, and then also like you have Idris Elba's character with these two goons just chasing him around, trying to look for him, find missing money that he so-called stole or whatever. And have you guys ever seen Crooklyn? You know, the dad in that played Loretta Devine's husband in this one. So so he ends up saving like Idris Elba's character at the end. And that's all I'm gonna go to for this movie, you guys. It ends up having a happy ending. They find out that Chris Brown's character can really sing, and he's like the youngest kid. TK, what is that? Stop giving me random stuff. TK, what are you doing? I just realized, you guys, I had completely left Chris Brown's character out. So like he's the youngest boy with this hidden singing talent or whatever, and nobody realizes it until there's a club scene and he starts to actually sing in it. And actually his version of This Christmas is one of my top three favorite Christmas songs, because I mean, he just pulled it off. He just made it work. He just did his thing on that song, y'all. But yeah, So his character, he just wants everybody to be together, and like it really frustrates him that it's not. And like he's a photographer as like a hobby and stuff, so he just goes around and takes pictures of like the family's happiest moments and stuff like that. And then they find out that he has this singing talent, and of course, since the father used to be a singer, Loretta Devine's character isn't too keen on him singing. And so to keep it a secret, like nobody in the family tells her that he can sing. And she ends up finding out at the end, and she's more accepting to it once she hears how good he is. But that's all I'm going to tell you about this, you guys. Great movie. Great movie. Number 2 on my list. Because I love it. I do absolutely love it. Last and final best for last movie has to be Best Man's Holiday. Okay. Best Man Holiday just has everything. Like, if you guys know the full cast in that movie, then you know why it has to be number one. Best Man, the first one, was just overall bomb and classic. The fact that they came out with this recreation for a holiday sequel was just everything to me. Like, the music was good. The fact that they made like Morris Chestnut's character, who's supposed to be, well, not supposed to be, he is this big shot ball player, and he ends up being family man, God, and his morals just are so perfect. Like, just perfect overall, because you wouldn't think that a man who has that much fame and money or whatever would be so into those values. And he just totally changes the game with that movie. But it's also sad because my girl dies in there. And like, that was the really sad part. But it helped because he had friends to support him. He had his kids to still take care of, and they kind of held her up until the end, the very, very end. Like, the support and sisterhood that she had from her girls was just overpowering. And I know I said I didn't like really sad movies to be in my top 5, but this movie just had everything going for it. I'm not going to go into details about Best Man Holiday, because if you have not seen it, you really need to just go watch it. Because it's definitely a movie for the books. The cast is everything. The movie is everything. The message that the movie sends is everything. So I am just going to leave that at that. Go watch Best Man Holiday. Happiness. Laugh a little. Cry a little. But look at the overall message that the movie brings. And look at the values that it installs. I mean, it has everything in there. Terrence Howard with the comedy. And they're supposed to be remaking another one. There's supposed to be a third one. And I think that's going to be based off of Quentin's character, which is Terrence Howard's character. So I'm looking forward to seeing that. I hope we don't have to wait like almost another decade for it. But I'm hoping it comes out soon. It's going to suck that Mia's not going to be a part of it, which was Monica Calhoun's character that died in it. But you guys just need to go see it. But this is all I'm going to say for this vlog, you guys. Those are my values. Those are my top 5 favorite African-American, Black, urban, whatever you want to call it, movies. Top 5. I may do another one with just like overall Christmas movies. If you guys are interested in seeing that, and if you blow this post up. So, I don't know how it's going to go. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That's it. I'm going to conclude it here. And I will be back for part 2 for the Jingle Jangle review. I love you guys.
own rings. I ain't really got a list of expensive things. I just want you to my